Hey guys, I'd like to welcome you back to another Ark Survival Evolved video. Today, we're going to be taking a look at the Xbox Update V7.4.1.0. Release date supposed to be September 15th. More than likely, knowing Ark devs, we won't get until October 15th or later. Well, let's hope for the best, guys, and hopefully it'll come out on the day they say so this time. If you haven't had a chance to look at the patch notes yet, I'll be posting them up on screen right about now. I'm not going to get into the tech stuff. The rendering and a few other things are the great addition to the game. But this video, we're going to be focusing on the two flyers. One which has a saddle and is rideable. And the other one is a glider. And also the new night vision glasses. And seeing if we could figure out a use for them, because they look pretty much worthless to me. So, with that said, let's go ahead and hop on one of these bad boys behind me here, which I have no idea how to pronounce their name. I will post it up above screen here, and you guys can try your hardest yourself at home, or wherever the hell you're at, to pronounce it. So here we go. Alright guys, the first thing you're going to notice here is the saddle. It is absolutely hideous. It's a freaking Gallimaya saddle stuck in the back of a Pteranodon saddle that was stretched out. Ark devs look like they spent about 5 minutes coming up with the design for this thing. Besides that, that's the only complaint I have so far. First thing you're going to notice is that we can go left, we can go right, and we can go backwards without any forward motion at all. Also, we can go up and down, same way as with a Quetzal. So, go ahead and see what we can pick up here. I know for a fact, from already testing it out a little bit, Dilos are definitely the biggest thing that you're able to pick up. Let's grab one here. Now, once you have the Dilo up here, if we do have an attack, but you cannot attack anything you have in your claws. Let's go ahead and drop him. You're probably interested in is how the hell is this thing actually attached to walls. The same thing, you go up to a wall, you push the same exact button as you do when you go to land. Boom, there you go, you're latched on. Now you cannot move up or down or side to side while latched onto the wall. You can also latch on the surfaces of buildings and surfaces of redwood trees, which will fly over the redwood forest real quick and we'll check that out. Rain has stopped, and we've made it to the redwood forest. Let's go ahead and take a look at one of these redwood trees and see how easy it is to land on. Boom. There you go, guys. Just like on the rocks, same exact thing. Can't move up or down. Go in a different view here so we can get a better view. Just like everything else in Ark, it doesn't actually look like he's holding on to the tree, just awfully close to it. Hopefully when the final game comes out, hopefully they improve on that. Like, yo, what up, dude? Chillin'. So the same way to get off the tree. Push the takeoff button. We take off. Push back. Camera views. Get these smaller redwood trees. Latch onto them. No, you cannot. So only the big redwood trees are able to be latched onto. Let's go to the top, make sure that it's not just a one spot type deal. Oh no. Alright. Try this tree out. Alright. Alright, well, you cannot pull your weapon out in the driver's seat. Oh yes, you can. Take that back. So you can land this guy on the side of a wall somewhere and take shots at people. That is cool. So if you had two people on here with you, both had guns, they were shooting or whatever, you landed on the side of somebody's base, you could take shots at them if you had a rocket. I mean, it has some aspects to PvP here that could play out. But it'd be awesome, especially if you're somebody's building in the Redwood Forest. Make it easy to raid them. Easier, I could say. I don't know how easy it would actually make it, but easier. Alright guys, we got one more dino to look at, so we're gonna fly over to my other base and take a look at it, and we'll be right back. Okay guys, we're back. And we're looking at the final dino being added to this update. And, well, I really don't know. Every time you pick the damn thing up, you hold it like this. There's no sitting on your shoulder. There's no carrying it like the dodo bird. You gotta carry it like this everywhere you go. Forwards, reverse, left, right. I guess if you have it in your hands, you're just always chilling with it out. Let's go ahead and change camera views here. Go ahead and jump on this guy. And yeah, still out, no matter what. Just chilling. Imagine if you had three people in the saddle right now. Each of you had one of these things. Once again, I don't know if I mentioned what this thing's name is, which I cannot pronounce, so I'll put it all over the screen here. I don't know. These names are absolutely ridiculous. But yeah, actually, three guys around the saddle, these up there. Something to see, I guess. Alright guys, we're gonna take a look at the amazing ugly ass bird here. It's like a rat slash chicken. We're gonna see what its capabilities are as gliding. So here we go. Also, if you guys haven't seen any of my other videos before and you want to take a look at the actual boat we're on right now and how it was made, I have a video for that which will be somewhere on the screen right about now. Also, if you want to wait to the end of the video, there should be a link in the descriptions below to it. Alright, so here we go. Change your camera view. We're gonna make the giant leap and change back. And we're flying. A lot like a parachute. We are able to go left, right, also able to go backwards. That's kind of cool. I can direct this guy in. Camera view. See if we can actually fly back to the tree boat. Oh, okay. Besides this dude being annoying and being ugly, he does have a purpose here. This is kind of cool. Sure, I'll find some reason to use this guy in one of my videos and when I'm playing on the Xbox version of Ark. Not really a big fan of the PC version unless I'm running some sort of mod. It's kind of fun to go and mess around with, spawn stuff in. So the only way to get off this guy is to throw him. You can't put him away or anything, so if you accidentally throw him, then you're screwed. So go ahead and pick him back up again. See him up there. Come on, Ark, don't crash on me. Jump. We're gliding, and then we can throw him. Alright guys, that's the last tame that's going to be in the new update. Now, the last thing we have to look at is the night vision glasses. Let's go ahead and change the gamma. Better if I spell it right. Gamma. Change it to 1. We can actually get a really good look. You can see it's dark. Go ahead and equip the night vision goggles. Boom. There you go. Oh, don't crash, Ark. Yeah, hopefully it doesn't make a difference in Xbox version, but when you're playing the PC version, anything that comes on your screen like this is definitely going to cause a little bit of a issue of lagging. Which is not really an issue unless I'm using the recording software I am using today. Peter just doesn't like it. So, same thing with this. I mean, it looks cool. I'm not really sure what the purpose is going to be to it. I did test this out earlier. underwater, and you're able to see a little bit clearer than if you're wearing goggles, especially at night underwater. I guess if somebody was wanting to go under there and tame at night, or taming something, a boza or something, and get stuck down there in the middle of the night taming it, they had some goggles with them, night vision glasses with them. They can pull them out and put them on. Besides that, I don't know what the purpose of these things are. Anyways, guys. Well, I hope you stuck around to the end of the video and enjoyed some point of it, maybe just checking the stuff out. Sorry I couldn't be a little bit more entertaining. I do have a cold, so thank you for bearing with me. Also, if you guys haven't, if this is the first video you guys have checked out of mine, please check the other ones out. There'll be a link to them in the description. Also, to my Facebook page and to Twitter and to Twitch, because I do a lot of live streaming. So, if you guys ever want to check out another one of my videos, all links are in the description below. Besides that, guys, thanks for watching. I'll see you later.